movies are there to show the aspects of the sculpture that exist in time. In other words, a cup on a table doesn't mean anything until you've got water in it and are drinking out of it. And in the same case, a spaceship doesn't mean anything unless it's landing on Mars. So the movie, in a way, is kind of like a propaganda film to show about how our rituals in the studio work. Well, I spent my youth being an avid consumerist, and because I'm an active participant in consumer culture, I'm more authorized to comment on it. I'm not just a hater, part of it. And growing up, brands like BMW were superior to brands like Chevrolet, and brands like Chanel are supreme in the world of fashion. So I thought, what are the real brands? What are the brands that represent humanity? And NASA, to me, was the icon of all knowledge. It's science, it's in a lot of ways faith. It asks the same questions that religion asks. Are we alone? Where did we come from? And in that sense, we go to Mars to study a planet that's very much like our own. Science is a comparative act, so you need something like Mars to understand something. Films like 10 Bullets show the ethics of the workplace. These are movies about organization, things about getting enough rest and being on time, getting a proper diet and exercise, and the methodology of building. Movies like Color show our color code. We have a very kind of rigid manner in which we build things. It might not look like it, but in order to make a spaceship have the consistency and the qualities of everything else in our space program, we have guidelines in which we make things. For example, we never paint the plywood after we cut it. We paint it before so that you see the cut, so that you see the screws and the glue drips and the cum stains on the wood. There's no specific message or agenda behind the space program other than to convey the values of the studio, which are of transparency. I believe that the only real advantage that the artist has over industry is her fingerprints. Apple could never make something as flawed and human as one of my sculptures, but I could never make something as perfect as an iPhone. There's a generation of artists embracing digital printing, CNC milling, digital technology. The advantage of the individual is that your flaws say, I was here. Additionally, you can't go to another planet without recognizing how your presence changes the culture of the locals. That's been going on since the beginning of the homogenesis. So for the past 500 years, we've been going to, the white people have been going to brown people's places and knocking down the round buildings and setting up cinder block factories. That's why the symbol of the space program is a cinder block. Our space program will be made of cinder blocks. Well, Van and I have been working together since 9/11. We've made movies together that show the aspects of the sculpture that exist in time, or the ritual aspects of the sculptures. It's very short movies. The first ones were called Nutsies from 2001 and led up to 2005. And then we made movies of 10 Bullets and Color. These are all streaming. You can see them all at www.10bullets.com. This movie, A Space Program, is our first feature. It's 72 minutes long, so it qualifies as a feature. And it's got a beginning, middle, and end. This isn't some dumb art movie. I mean, it's dumb, don't get me wrong. But it makes sense, and there won't be anything that you can't understand, no matter how little or much you know about it. Well, I think about it like this. I'm a sculptor, and I live and die to make sculpture. But more people will see images of my sculpture on a 2.5-inch screen than they'll ever see in real life. And that's the reality. You can't ignore that. That's the world that we live in. And it's a fantastic world. It's a world where I can share my ideas. However, they're very different in real life than they are on the screen. So the movies help show, you know, instead of a photograph, you can move around space and understand it. You can see how we really use these things. We don't use the word performance or performance art. We use the word demonstration or live demonstration. I also think it's worth noting that there's an elitism to the art world that I don't that I try and avoid. And that elitism is the wall plaque, the description on the wall that says I always believe that there should be a description on the wall next to my art that says you don't need to read this to understand what you're looking at.